I guess the farm started, mom and dad started it in 1984 down in Peel County. And they started with 13 cows and grew until they outgrew that barn down there. And then we bought this farm from my grandparents and moved up here. And I guess moved up here in 96 with 40 cows and just progressively grew it to where we're at now, around 70. The attempt is to have high classifying cows, preferably very good two-year-olds, and progressing to high very good or excellent cows. We try to feed a high forage diet. We look for big framey cows that progress into excellent cows, hopefully down the future, and make enough milk to pay the bills. I guess the tools that we use that have been, I guess, successful to this herd is classification number one. We use it just to basically reinforce we're doing the right thing and going down the right path for what we're looking for and where our herd is sitting and our weaknesses and our strengths are. DHI, just to kind of monitor that the cows are actually doing what you think they're doing. And proof sheets, and I guess it's transformed into genomics lately, that we use just to figure out our individual matings. I guess the most important cow family to our shield would be our Rita family. It's developed into by far our deepest cow family, where they're starting to produce multiple star brood cows and being very milky and high fat test now. I guess depth for the herd, we have the Emily family who produces basically the same type of cow, not quite as deep, not quite as often, but they are high fat cows and big frames. And the Paulas, they're an off branch of Paula James, who's twice nominated All-Canadian. And then our Jenny family, they are more of our run-of-the-mill barn cow, but high, very good classifying cows. I guess our agricultural achievements, they would be Squibland Paula James. We sold her to Marc Comtois, and he showed her at the Royal, and she was fourth and fifth in consecutive years. For something we owned, we showed Emily Gemini. We showed her at our county show, and I guess she was first place in her class four or five years, and twice reserve grand. I guess the only advice I'd have for a young breeder looking to be successful would be stick to your own philosophy and don't jump on the fads. And just run down the road that you think is right. It's receiving this second shield is pretty humbling for our family. It was something we strive for after winning the first one, which came unexpectedly. And I guess it's the result of us sticking to our guns. And it means, I guess, a lot more now to prove that we're on the right track and we're doing things the right way for the right reasons. So I guess the future plans is more or less just keep on keeping on, doing things the way we've always done them and just tweaking things along the way and making the improvements and the adjustments as we go.